Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will learn how to install the current PHP version on Windows 10. With that, we will also run a sample PHP program after installing. Let's start. Go to the web browser. On Google, type PHP and press enter. The official website is visible. Click on it, php.net. After that, directly go to the downloads button. And here we have the Windows version 8.3.9, the current version we want for Windows. So I'll click here. Now we have for 64-bit Windows, non-thread safe as well as thread safe version. We want the thread safe version. So I'll click on the zip file. Only 30 MB. Let's wait. We have downloaded it. Right click, click show in folder. So here is the file. You can extract it on Windows 10. Right click, extract to. Now here is the file. Okay, let us rename. This looks fine now. Okay, copy. Go to C drive, program files, and paste it here. Right click, paste, continue. Here is the file, open it, copy the path, right click, copy, minimize, go to start, type environment variables, and here it is, edit the system environment variables. Click open. Under the advanced tab, go to environment variables and click on it. Now go to system variables, path, and double click. Click new and paste the same path. Right click, paste. Okay. Okay. And the last okay. Now we have successfully installed. Let us verify. Go to start. Type cmd. Click open. Okay. Type the command php space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. Here it is. We successfully installed PHP 8.3.9. Now let us run our first program. You can create a program on the desktop or you can go to any drive. Let's say I'll go to E drive. You can also go to the D drive. Now let me create a new folder. Right click, new Amit. That's my project folder. Now go inside, right click, new txt document. So let me name it, let's say index. I'll change the extension to .php. When I'll press enter, it will ask me, do you want to change the file extension? Click yes. So here a lot of users face issues because they are unable to see the extension. So it's very easy. Go to view and select file name extensions. I already did it. When I'll remove it, let's say you won't be able to see the extension, so you won't be able to change the extension. Always select this, okay, and change it like I just did. And now we have a PHP file. Right click. You can edit with Notepad++ or even Notepad. A lot of users don't have Notepad++. So click open with. I'll select Notepad. Okay. Now let us write our first program quickly, PHP. Okay, here I'll type echo. Under that, I'll type Amit Divan. So echo will print whatever message you'll add inside. So now the text Amit Divan will print. File, save. Okay. Now let us go to the same path. So this is our path. We can directly copy this path, or I'll also teach you how to use cmd. Okay, so now let us reach the E directory. Type E colon. Now we will reach the E directory. Here, let me type dir, and now you can see all the folders inside the E directory. That means we are here now. We have one folder and two files. We want to enter the Amit folder. Type cd space Amit and press enter. And we have a single file. We can recheck dir. And here is our file index.php. To run it, type php index.php, that's it, and press enter. It will show my name. Why? Because we added the name here, Amit Diwan. So we ran our first PHP program. If you want a free PHP tutorial, you can refer the link in the description of this video. With that, we also have a Bootstrap and HTML free course. Thank you for watching the video.